Are you ready for some good news? When you pray the Word of God, you're praying powerfully in the Spirit, which means that you are praying according to God's will. Today's text comes from Ephesians chapter 6. And take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the Word of God, praying at all times in the Spirit with all prayer and supplication. To that end, keep alert with all perseverance, making supplication for all the saints. That's Ephesians 6, 17, 18. Paul's exhortation to pray in the Spirit at all times makes clear the pathway to a powerful prayer life. Prayer is only effective to the extent it is prayer in the Spirit. While some theological circles have asserted that praying in the Spirit comes only via the spiritual gift of tongues, there are certainly other ways in which we can pray in the Spirit. Perhaps the most powerful form of praying in the Spirit is praying the pure Word of God. Because all Scripture is God-breathed, all of God's Word is full of the Spirit. There is no divorce in God's mind between the Word and the Spirit. So when you pray the Scriptures, you're praying what the Spirit has inspired. Praying God's Word is therefore praying in the Spirit. One of the reasons that praying God's Word is so powerful is that scriptural prayer is aligned with God's will. John assures us of this in his first epistle, that if we ask anything according to His will, He hears us. See, God will never be persuaded to violate His own will that is always laden with good intentions towards His children. If a cocaine addict asks God for more cocaine, I trust that the Lord will by no means grant the poisonous request. But when you return God's own promises to Him, you can be certain that you are praying in alignment with God's own heart. You can pray in the Spirit at all times by rooting your prayer life in the Word of God. And when you do, you can be assured that you are profoundly connected with God's own heart. God has ordained that through your prayers, He will perform what He's already promised in His Word to you. And that's the gospel. That's today's daily devotional. And if you missed this important message that begins our new series about praying pure Word, hope you'll get it. It's free, and it's at sharingthelight.org.